Hello dear students, welcome to my online English class. Today I will discuss the second part of the class, right from our verbs. I have discussed the class in the previous part. So this is the second part of the class. In the previous class, I have discussed the primary rules, the V1 forms, that means present form of the verbs, how to use V1 form or present form in the sentences. Today I will discuss the remaining part of the sentence. So according to the class, that means today I am going to discuss the past form of the verbs, that means V2 form of the verbs. I hope you will be attentive in the class, and you must watch the class, especially the student of class 6 to 10 will be benefited if you watch the class. So I hope so. You must watch the class with great attention. So let's start our today's class. First of all, I have discussed in the previous class, before going to fill up or answering the right form of verbs, you have to observe the time indicator of the sentence. That means there will be some important words that will help you to identify whether the tense is in present form, past form, or in future tense. So accordingly, if you see any past indicator in the sentence, we have to use the V2 form of the verb. That means, if you see a sentence that is in the form of past indefinite tense, but in the affirmative form, then you have to use V2 form in the sentence. That means you will have many time indicators here. That means past, yesterday, last past, once upon a time, long ago, just like this sentence, words, and it will help you to identify that is in past indefinite tense. So here, if you see the sentence is in past tense, then you have to use the V2 form. Besides this, if you see it is time, it is high time, wish and fancy in a sentence, you must use the V2 form, or that means the past form of verbs in this sentence. So we'd like to see an example here. In this sentence, we are watching a time indicator. That means the time adverb is helping us to identify if that the sentence is in past form. And here we are observing that the sentence is in affirmative form. There is no negative sign here. So we must use V2 form, that means past form of verb, in the sentence. So the right answer will be, he came here. That means he came here yesterday wearing mask. Now we will see the second example. If you see wish in a sentence, and if you see be in the bracket or in the box, if you see be verb, be, then you must be careful using the verb. That means here you have to use were in place of be verb. Whether the subject is present form, singular, plural, third person, second person, or first person, that is not fact. You have to use only were in the bracket or in the blank. So right answer will be, I wish I were an honest minister. So dear students, let's see V3 form. That means V3 is used. Where to use V3? We will see now. In all perfect tense, we have to use verb in the past participle form. That means V3 form. We have to use V3 form. Here, you have to use the time indicating verb. That means lately. As we have observed that here there is a time indicator lately, so we must be sure that the sentence is in. We have to make the sentence, or we have to give in the sentence, the structure of present perfect tense. So according to the structure of present perfect tense, we know we have to use have or has before the main verb, and we have to use the participle form of verbs after have and has. Here, second thing is, we are observing that the subject is third person singular number. So we have to use has here, and after have or has, we have to use the participle form of the verbs. That means V3 form of verbs. V3 is used in all passive voice. If you see, the subject of a sentence is inanimate object. That means not personal subject. This is not personal subject. So we have to think and we have to take decision that this sentence must be made in the passive form. Here, and another sign is by. We know it is the sign of passive voice. So we have to think that we have to give, we have to make it the sentence in passive structure. So according to the structure or rules of passive voice, we should use the helping verb before the main verb. And after helping verb, we have to use the past participle form of the verb. So the right answer will be, English is taught by him. That means taught is the past participle form of the verb teach. And before this, we have used is. That means helping verb is, as it is in present indefinite tense. So we have to use this structure, and we have to use V3 form because this is a passive voice. So we are sure. That means we know. We have already known that we have to use V3 form of or past participle form of verb in all passive voice. After have, has, had, gave, got, be, been, having, you must remember and must keep it in your brain that if we see this verb before the blank or before the bracket, we must use past participle form of the verb in the bracket or in the blank. Because we know after this helping verb, that means have, has, had, get, got, be, been, having, we have to use V3 form or past participle form of the verbs. The example is, he has made a flower garden. The right answer will be, he has made a flower garden. That means, as we have seen, has before the bracket, so we have made. That means we must be sure, or we must use the past participle from after has. She and others have used must. That means here, as we have have, so we have used here. That means here must are used to protect the virus. That means this is passive voice and this is present perfect tense. So we have to use to have kitri after have. Now, if you see these time indicating words like lately, recently, already, just now, in a sentence, you must use have, has, and bhitri or not past participle form of bhav. That means, if you see these time indicating words, that means lately, recently, already, just now, this sentence will help you to be sure that this is present perfect tense. This is the sign of present perfect tense. So we have to use, or you have to use, have and has according to the subject. If the subject is third person singular number, that means you have to use has. And if the subject is first person singular person or plural number, you have to use have. And then you have to use the past participle form of the verb after this helping verb. Now see an example. He buy a mask recently. That means, as we have seen, that means recently here, this time indicating word is helping us to identify this sentence as present perfect tense. So we have to use have or has before the main verb. That means, as this is third person singular number, as the subject is third person singular number, so I have used has, and after has we have used bhitri form of the verb bought. That means, he has bought a mask recently. Now we will see before form or verb plus ing, when we will use ing with the verbs. We must remember, or we must know, in all continuous tense we have to use ing with the verb. Then we have to add ing with the main verb. That means, according to the structure of continuous tense, we have to use be verb and then we have to use ing with the main verb. So here we are watching an example, and you have to remember that when you will be sure that this is in present continuous tense. While you will see now or at this moment in a sentence, you will be sure that we have to make the sentence in present continuous tense. So, according to the structure, you have to use am, is, are before the main verb, and then you have to add ing with the main verb. Here, the right answer will be, as we have observed now, so we have to make it in present continuous tense. So according to the rules of present continuous tense, we have used here is as the subject is third person singular number, so we have used is here, and then we have added ing with the main verb. So answer is, he is washing his hands now. ing is added with the verbs in all perfect continuous tense. In all perfect continuous tense, we have to use ing with the main verbs. That means, how we can be sure that this sentence is present or any kind of perfect tense? If you see since or for before the time, that means if you see time indicating words after since or for, then you will be sure that the sentence is present or any kind of perfect continuous tense. So you have to use the structure according to the tense also. Here we are observing that since morning, so we are sure that the sentence will be the sentence is present perfect continuous tense. So we have to give the structure of present perfect continuous tense according to the structure of present perfect tense. That means we have to use have, has, and have to. We have to add ing with the main verb. So let's watch the answer. He has been waiting for me since morning. That means we have used has been according to the structure of present perfect tense. We have to use have been or has been before main verb, and then we have to add ing with the verb. So the answer is he has been waiting for me since morning. The most important point is that you have to use ing with the verb after all prepositions except two. If you see any prepositions before the verb, you have to use ing with the main verb. That means this is the very important rule. The example is, before making the right form of verbs or doing the right form of verbs, we have to observe that there is a preposition before the verb. As soon as you will see the preposition before the verb, you must use or add ing with the main form of the verb. So the right answer is killing. That means we use hand sanitizer for killing germs. ing is added with the second verb of a simple sentence or with the second verbs of a close of a sentence. That means if you see two verbs in a simple sentence, you have to add ing with the second verb. And if you see two verbs in a close of a sentence, then you have to use ing with the main verb. The example is, we saw them play in the field. That means this is a simple sentence. So in a simple sentence, we must have, there must be a simple finite verb. But we are watching another verb is here. So as soon as we will see second verb in a simple sentence, we have to add ing with the main verb. So the right answer will be, playing. We saw them playing in the field. In making gerund or participle, we have to add ing is added with the verb. That means if we want to make participle or gerund, we have to use ing or we have to add ing with the main verb. That means here we are watching a sentence. Swimming is a good exercise. If you see the beginning in the if you see verb in the beginning of sentence, you have to add ing with the verb. That means if you see any kind of verb at the beginning of the sentence, then you have to make it a gerund. That means you have to add ing with the verb. So swimming is a good exercise.
After some prepositional phrase, such as with a view to, look forward to, addicted to, get used to, ing is added. That means if you see the phrase, prepositional phrase with a view to, look forward to, addicted to, get used to, you have to use ing or you have to add ing with the main verb. He read. He read more with a view to making a good result. That means he read more with a view to making a good result. So, dear students, I am going to end the class today here, and I will discuss the remaining part of the right form of verbs in the next class. I hope all of you will watch the next class also, and you must watch the class I have already taken. And if you watch the series of the classes, that means first part, second part and third part, then you must be benefited, I think. And I am ending here with this hope. That means you will watch the class and will be benefited. Thank you very much. Thank you all.